What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So I'm going to show you guys how to install, set up and configure RetroArch for your Nintendo Switch. Go to the link in the description, download the file for your device. Once the file has been downloaded, you're going to get the RAR file, extract the contents, you're going to get the RetroArch folder. Plug in your SD card, go to the Switch folder of the extracted, copy the NRO file and go to your SD card, go into the Switch folder and paste it here. Now the RetroArch itself is a very beefy file because it contains all the assets and cores and database. So make sure that you have ample space in your SD card. Copy the RetroArch folder and paste it to the root of your SD card. I already have it pasted to the root of my SD card. A couple of things that you guys need to do. You need to set up the BIOS files and also you need to create a ROMs folder of the preferred ROMs that you want to play. So let's just go ahead and create the ROMs folder first. Create a ROM folder somewhere in your PC and create some subfolders like this. And then just place the ROM files into the preferred folders. Once that's done, just copy the ROMs folder, go into the RetroArch folder of the SD card and paste it there. So now next thing are the BIOS files. Just get a hold of the BIOS files I already mentioned on the video. You can pause the video and check that out, or you can also check out the descriptions I haven't mentioned there. So these are the BIOS files. Just copy them all together and go into the RetroArch folder of your SD card. Go into cores. You're going to find the system folder inside the core folder. Paste them. Alright guys, so everything that needed to be copied and pasted is done. I'm going to show you the next step on the Nintendo Switch. So let's just go ahead and activate full RAM mode before running RetroArch. Press and hold the R button and select an application. Let it take you to the homebrew menu. If you're not going to activate the full RAM mode, chances are you're going to end up with an error message. Go ahead and run RetroArch. And here we're going to change and tweak some settings in order to get the best performance and also the best look. As you can see, this is not the default look. This is the XMB look. I'm going to show you guys how to select that. Go to settings, go to user interface, third option menu. It will be set to Ozone by default. Go ahead and select XMB and head back, restart RetroArch. Every time you're going to apply any system-wide settings, make sure that you restart RetroArch. After you change the outlook of the main menu, I'm going to show you guys how to magnify these options in order to make them look a bit more bigger and more visible. So I kind of like this look. It's because it has an aesthetic feeling to it and it has all the menus aligned in such a nice way. And also I love the PlayStation-esque look. So let's just go ahead to the settings, go to user interface. Under the appearance, the very first option that you'll see, menu scale factor, go ahead and select it. Now I have selected it to 1.25. By default, it's going to be set to 1.00. The preferred selection according to me is in between 1.20 to 1.30. It's actually based on how your eye preference is. Go ahead and select the desired option and don't forget to restart RetroArch. So now we are going to change the video settings. Go ahead to the video and scroll down, activate bilinear filtering like I did. If the screen turns black, press any button. So after activating the bilinear filtering, let's just go ahead to the scaling option and then just change the aspect ratio to 16:9. Okay, after that, let's just go into input, scroll over to the hotkeys section. Hotkeys are basically the shortcut commands which is going to give you ease of access when you're going to be in game. So these are the list of commands. Please set them according to your preference. In order to set them, just press the A button and press the desired key that you want to set as the hotkey. But before setting up the hotkey, make sure that you set the hotkey enable key. It's going to enable you to activate these hotkey commands. For this one, I selected the L button. In order to activate these other commands, I have to press and hold the L button, press the desired hotkey command that I have set. So after that, one last thing that we're going to do is that go ahead to the online updater and scroll all the way down, activate on-demand thumbnail downloads like I did. It's going to add in the cover pictures of the games that you have added to the system. So now we're going to go ahead and add the ROM files, go to scan directory, look for the RetroArch folder. Inside the RetroArch folder, look for the ROM folder. Select the ROMs folder and scan this directory. So it's going to vary depending on the number of ROM files that you have added. Give it a little bit of moment to complete the scanning process. Alright, it has been completed. Let's just head back. All these console icons has been activated. So let's just go ahead and run one of the games. While running for the first time, you're gonna have to select the core. So you're going to get a bunch of options. I'm going to mention the preferred core for best experience in the description. Please go ahead and check out. So as you can see, the game runs perfectly fine. Depending on the emulator, you're going to get a little bit of lag here and there, especially on the more graphics and processor hungry systems like PlayStation and Nintendo 64 and some of the SNES ROMs that requires the FX core chip. So this is how you install, setup, and configure RetroArch in order to get the preferred performance for your Nintendo Switch. So if I have missed out anything to mention on my video, please make sure to mention it on the comment section. If you have found this tutorial useful, please make sure to like and subscribe. Don't forget to comment. Dr. Root 7 signing off. Peace.